Experience exists.
The moment you receive Gnan, the experience does not leave. How can it? The experience of that which I gave you, the Gnan, remains forever. The effects of your previous karma, however, tend to cloud the experience. I cannot change that. That effect has to be endured.
Dada, we do not think of it as suffering anymore.
That is a different matter. But the accounts are there nevertheless. Some have many accounts while some have a few. Some may have to suffer more. What does it matter? I have lifted you to the state of pure soul. You may experience mild suffocation because of your past karma.
Experience of the self, experience of the body.
When mental problems, that is adhi, physical problems, that is vyadhi, or external problems, that is upadhi, do not bother you, then you know that your gnan is real. If you lose your wallet with a lot of money in it, then you will experience some inner restlessness, and at such time, if you say from within, this is vyavasthit, you will be able to pacify Chandulal. That is file number one. This inner experience is the experience of the soul. If, on the other hand, Chandulal is unable to remain calm and he loses his peace of mind, then that is the experience of the physical body, that is Dehathyas. Are you familiar with these two experiences?
Yes, the bliss prevails. Such is the experience, Dada.
What else remains?
The other path is Kramik. This is the science of Akram. This is the Gnan of the Vitrags, that is the fully enlightened ones, the omniscient, the absolute knowers. There is no difference in the knowledge of the two paths. After this Gnan, you experience the soul. What else is left for you to do? All you need to do is follow the Agnyas of the Gnani Purush. These Agnyas become your religion. These Agnyas represent your penance. My Agnyas are such that they never interfere or become restrictive in any matters related to the worldly life. Even though you live the worldly life, nothing of the worldly life will affect you. Such is the glory of the science of Akram. This extraordinary science is such a wonder that it keeps you alert about your true self from within. Even as one is involved in negative acts, he is warned from within immediately. Therefore, there is no need for you to do anything. The science of this Gnan itself takes over all doership. All you have to do from now on is make a firm decision, that is Nischay, that you want to follow Dada Shri's Agnyas. These Agnyas will protect you from influences of every kind. The warnings will come even in your sleep. Now, what more do you need? Follow the path of my Agnyas if you want to be liberated within one more lifetime.
Agna is the religion.
The one who desires liberation does not need to be involved in doership. The one who wants moksha needs only Gnan and the Gnani's Agnyas. The one who wants to go to heaven or desires worldly pleasures needs doership. There is no need for any penance or renunciation in the path of liberation. The only thing required is to meet a Gnani. Then the acquisition of his Agnyas becomes your religion and your penance. Gnan, that is correct knowledge, Darshan, that is correct vision, Charitra, that is correct conduct, and Tap, that is penance, are the four pillars of the foundation of moksha. The direct result of Agnyas is freedom, because all the four pillars are contained in them.
Stay with the Gnani.
Never before has love arisen for the Jnani. Once this love arises, all solutions follow. In your previous lives, you have not acquired anything else besides a spouse and children. The enlightened ones have said that one should stay with the Jnani after acquiring Jnan from him.
In what sense can we stay with him?
There should be no devotion in any other direction except in the direction of the Jnani. We know that this is Akram science, and people have brought with them innumerable files, and therefore, I have given you the freedom to go and deal with these files. But I am not letting you go away completely. I am letting you go so that you can deal with your files with equanimity. Otherwise, it is desirable that you remain with the Jnani. This aside, you should feel troubled from within night and day that you are not able to take full advantage of this opportunity and be in the presence of a Jnani. Your only desire should be to increase the opportunity to be with the Jnani. Your innermost desire should be that your files decrease so that you can give yourself the opportunity to be with him. Mahavidaya Kshetra awaits such a person. The one in whom the awareness of Shuddhatma is established cannot remain here in the Bharat Kshetra, that is our world. The rule is that the one who acquires the awareness of the soul goes to Mahavidaya Kshetra. He does not remain in this Dusham Kal, that is the current time cycle. With one or two more lifetimes in Mahavidaya Kshetra, after the darshan of the Tirthankar Sri Simandar Swami, one attains moksha. Such is the simplicity and ease of this path. Stay in my agnyas. Agnyas represent religion and penance. You have to settle all your files with equanimity. Stay in the agnyas as much as possible. The state of Lord Mahavir can be yours if you abide by them constantly. Look at the relative and look at the real, and your chit will not wander. However, the mind will still erupt with new thoughts, which will cause puzzles. If, after this Jnan, you follow the five Agnyas, you will be in bliss, just as Lord Mahavir was. I live with the same bliss. I am showing you this path, the very path that I have walked. Your spiritual awakening in the real realm is same as mine.
Dada Bhagwan na asim jai jai kar ho. Dada Bhagwan na asim jai jai kar ho. Dada Bhagwan na asim jai jai kar ho. Dada Bhagwan na asim jai jai kar ho.
The importance of the five agnas. Spiritual practice after Jnan.
Dada, what should one do spiritually after this Jnan?
The only endeavor is to follow the five agnas. One should not have any other endeavors. All other endeavors cause bondage. These five agnas release you from bondage.
Bliss with agnas.
Is there anything higher than your five agnas?
These five agnas are a fence protecting your priceless treasure. You have a fully enclosed fence. Nobody can take away the priceless treasure that I have given you. If this fence of five agnas becomes weak, then chances are someone will enter and spoil the contents. Then I have to come and repair the fence. So, if you stay within the five agnas, I guarantee you eternal bliss. These five agnas are given for your protection. I have given you the Jnan and the knowledge of separation. But in order for this separation to prevail, I give you the five agnas for further protection. This age is that of Kali Yuga, that is deceit, dark age. And without protection, you are likely to be robbed of this invaluable treasure of Gnan. For the seed of Gnan to blossom into a full-bloomed tree, you will have to water it and nurture it. You will have to provide protection and create a small enclosure to protect the young plant.
Five Agnas leads to the state of the Lord.
The five Agnas are simple, are they not?
But they appear difficult in daily experience.
They are not difficult, but it seems that way because of the discharge of a large stock of your karmas from past lives. At such times, you need to be more aware. Spiritual laziness under such circumstances will not do at all. If you remain within my Agnas, you can experience the bliss of Lord Mahavir. It is the previous tendencies of the mind that do not let you stay in the five Agnas. Maintaining the knower known state, that is the state of I in the correct place as the knower or observer and the known being file number one, Chandulal, you will be beyond these tendencies of your mind. Do not accommodate these tendencies. Do not be pleased with any of your previous tendencies. They may express in all different ways and may dance around you and mesmerize you. That does not mean that you have slipped. They may even cause variable anxiety and tribulations. If this happens, it only clouds the state of your real bliss. If your peace is interrupted, it is because of these prior tendencies. With determination, you will be able to follow the Agnas. But the problems occur when one is indecisive. You have to make the decision. I want to stay within the Agnas. Such a determination is possible, is it not? If this is not possible on a daily basis, why not take one day at a time and experience the bliss that follows by resolutely following the Agnas every instant? I am not telling you to follow my Agnas. I am telling you to make a decision to follow my Agnas.
Unflinching decision makes you follow Agnas.
The greatest thing of all is to decide to follow Dada's Agnas. You should decide to do that. Do not concern yourself about whether you are able to do so or not. However much you are able to follow is correct and exact. At least be determined to follow them.
So, if they are not followed fully, is it acceptable?
No, not quite. You should be firm in your determination that you want to follow the Agnas. From the time you wake up, decide, I want to stay in and follow the Agnas. This decision will keep you in the Agnas, and that is all I want. I know the causal reason why you are not able to follow the Agnas. Your decision, however, is needed. Moksha is the reality of our Gnan. If you stay in the Agnas, moksha is guaranteed. There is no argument about it. Even if one does not want to follow the Agnas because he has attained the seed of Gnan, one day it is bound to grow. People ask me, what happens to those who have taken the Gnan but do not follow the Agnas? I tell them that they are not to be concerned about this. That is my concern because they have taken the Gnan from me. One's sins are destroyed in the fire of the Gnan. When one abides by the five Agnas, bliss will prevail. The task shall be accomplished if you follow the Agnas. I follow these Agnas constantly. The state that I am in is the state that is given to you. It will only work if the Agnas are followed. If one tried to attain this through his own efforts, he would not succeed even in 100,000 lifetimes. There are situations where one follows the Agnas through the medium of the intellect. This weakens the protective wall of the Agnas, even though he still may have the bhav to follow the Agnas. Therefore, one needs to be alert and attentive. Do pratikraman if you forget to follow the agnyas. Yes, it is human nature to forget. When you forget, do pratikraman by saying, Dada, please forgive me. I forgot to follow the agnyas for these 2 hours. I do want to follow your agnyas. Please forgive me. Through pratikraman, you will be relieved of your responsibility. Once enclosed in the protective sphere of the agnyas, nothing in the world will bother you. Karma will not bind you. Does it bind the one who is the giver of the agnyas? No, because they are given with a view to help others.
These are the agnyas of the Lord.
To follow Dada's agnyas does not mean that you are following A.M. Patel's agnyas. These are agnyas of the Lord of the 14 worlds, Dada Bhagwan. I am guaranteeing this. Yes, they are coming to you through my medium. Follow them. I myself stay within these agnyas. Jai Satchidananda.